Imagine you're at home reading a book or watching a movie. It's raining outside, freezing, but you feel good thanks to your energy management system, a very efficient one. You chose it based on ambitious criteria in terms of global warm, air quality, environmental footprint, budget control, and so on. And you got the best equipment and services that perfectly meet your needs and desires. Right now, you may say that you have a perfect picture of your actual performance. But now imagine that something needs to be changed or adjusted in order to maintain or improve your energy performance. Imagine that in order to realize these changes, you need the manufacturers or installers of your devices to adapt the settings of your equipment and energy chain. What if you needed to adjust your energy parameters following any weather changes, energy cost increase, or special needs? What if you couldn't do it alone? How would you feel if managing your energy system meant manipulating some knobs or sliders without knowing what they relate to? Fortunately, the Schneider Performance Model doesn't work like that. Fortunately, the model is built to provide flexibility and efficiency, and it is connected to day-to-day business reality. Actually, it can integrate our business evolutions, and it enables to manage globally our performance with the relevant set of tools in order to improve it through proper action plans. Our finance performance management model follows our organization matrix based on business units and operations, supported by global functions. This model aims at evaluating effectiveness and efficiency of the value created for our customers, and obviously for our group. Remember the beyond budget pillar of our finance performance model. We want to evaluate the potential of our activities from the market's point of view, while our management remains focused on the actions that are to be taken. This pillar itself relies on different specific and complementary steps and tools. Now let's talk about our group's objectives. Best companies have focus. That focus guides their actions and gives them purpose. We call this focus a company program. It translates our strategy into execution and helps everybody in the company align on common priorities. Operational goals are regularly defined, taking into account both company program vision and short-term evolutions in markets, economic situation, and competitors. The global company objectives are translated into business targets through KPIs, which will be continuously monitored throughout the year. The target phase is a crucial part for the performance management cycle. Target setting is initialized by end of year. Built by basket of offers, businesses, based on strategic inputs and high ambitions, these targets are then cascaded by the group down to operations, zones, and global functions. Targets are not a matter of using a crystal ball. They are defined based on market analysis and perspective and aim at beating the competition. To set the relevant baseline, the prior process is particularly important. It allows an apples-to-apples comparison from one year to another by restating previous year based on the new organizational structure for the current one. Don't forget that just like when managing our own energy chain, following our needs and weather changes, we need a measurement model that allows us to continuously monitor our performance. Our key actual finance performance KPIs are monthly P&L, balance sheet by country and by BU, global supply chain productivity, global function costs, and quarterly P&L by activity, and they are reflecting the level of performance of our organization. And because we want our commercial and financial results to always reach the best possible level, our model follows a continuous improvement cycle. It conducts us to identify and undertake relevant actions to properly allocate our resources in order to achieve our targets. Here, the quarterly rolling forecasts are one of our model's centerpieces. The forecast is a combination of the estimated current and non-current performance of specific actions. Forecasts work like a compass, continually showing what the best yearly possible performance could be, based on the existing situation and identified actions. In that sense, elaborating a forecast is also a decision-making process shared during the quarterly business review. That's when specific action plans are validated, and when all the parties commit on both means and results to fill the potential gap between forecasted results and targets. Obviously, the actions defined are then to be implemented, and actual results analysis will enable to measure their effective impact on our performance in regards to expected results. As you can see, our performance management model is a strong combination between a weather station, recording and displaying all current weather events, and a weather simulator, forecasting sunshine or rain based on strong and reliable analysis models. In fact, it is a complete and powerful management system that makes the decision-making process consistent, reliable, and results-oriented. But don't forget that there is no true efficient process without the right engagement and behaviors. Performance management requires for all of us, and especially for the finance team, transparency in the communication of results, reliability, and commitment to the defined action plan. It is our duty and responsibility to keep this management cycle reliable and efficient, and to use it as a compass towards enhanced performance.